Hello, welcome. I'm going to jump right into this so that I don't waste any of your time and you get an opportunity to try out what I'm talking about as soon as possible, because I know that I don't like video tutorials personally, because I always feel like I have to sit through an awful lot just to find out what I'm looking for. So the base idea here, as contained in my blog post about color matching tones and using curves to do it, is that I'm going to take my original image and I'm going to want to approximate the tones, the skin tones in particular, in my original image to match something similar to a target image of some sort. In this case, it's Vermeer's The Girl with the Pearl Earring. And the way I'll do this is that I'll set a couple of sample points in GIMP that will give me pixel values, and then I'll use curves to match those pixel values from my original image to my target image. To get sample points onto your image, you're going to control left click up in the rulers on your canvas and drag points down onto your canvas somewhere. And if your sample points dialog doesn't immediately show itself, you can open it up by going to Windows, Dockable Dialogs, Sample Points. Now, this will show me the RGB values of the pixel underneath each of these sample points. Okay, it'll also show me hue saturation value and CMYK breakdowns. In our case, we're going to want to use HSV, because what we want to do is find pixels that have similar levels of brightness in the skin tones between the two images. So, for instance, in my original image, maybe I want to find something around the 85%, and I'm going to find a corresponding 85% in the skin tones of my target image as well, like so. And I'll want now to match this slightly pinkish tone to the slightly more yellow tone from the painting. If I go back to Pixels and then activate my Curves dialog for my image, I'll be looking at a linear curve. Now, the nice thing about the Curves dialog is when it's active, if you hover your mouse over your canvas area, your cursor will turn into an eyedropper. This means that you can click and drag through your image, and for the pixels underneath the cursor at that point, you're going to see their values show up as a vertical line in your curves dialog. This makes it very handy for us, because now we have an area in the curve that this pixel's values will lie, and that's where we're going to adjust for these upper midtones. So, looking at my pixel values here, I can see my red needs to come down a little bit, 218 to 216, green needs to come down to about 185, and my blue needs to come down to about 164 along this vertical line. And that's what I'll do. I'll come to my red channel and say, on this vertical line, I'll click and drag a point down to about 215, 216, somewhere close. It doesn't have to be exact. My green channel, I'll bring it down to about 185. Quite a bit of magenta comes in by dropping the green channel here. And drop my blue channel down to, you know, much lower value, 164. Adds a much more yellowish cast to the image overall. And that gives me my first point. It should already get you pretty close, visually at least, or similar, to the tones that I'm looking for, and I think that they are. But to really get this curve to behave and give you the tones much closer, you're going to want to also look at darker tones as well. So we've been working up here in this upper mid-tones area of the curve. Now we're going to want to try to find something either in the middle or down towards the lower mid-tone values, if possible. So, clicking and dragging, I can see, well, down kind of in this shadowy area, I kind of get another curve point a little lower out, or I can go even darker. And that's what I'll do. While leaving the curves dialog open, I can click and drag these sample points around to different areas. I'll change this to HSV, and see I'm down in like 42% down here. So, I'm going to want to find a matching value of around 42% in my source image as well, like so. And clicking and dragging on the canvas to sample my points gives me the rough location of those pixel values on my curves. And it's just a matching game, once again, just like we did on the high tones. I'm into reds, and I see my reds need to come down. They're pretty close to being right. My greens need to come up just a hair here in the shadows to about 74. And my blues can come up just the tiniest bit as well. And that's the basic idea. Now, if I wanted to continue fine-tuning this, if the results weren't quite what I expected or it's not looking the way that I wanted to, I could go back and actually move my sample points into the upper range again, but this time using a different set of sample points or a different pixel, maybe around 79 or 80%, and figuring out where those lie on my curve, I would go back and readjust these original points that I placed. I wouldn't place new points. They tend to make too many abrupt changes in the overall curve. You want these curves to be as smooth as possible, with some nice gradual changes to change the toning of your image. Any multiple points will inevitably lead to abrupt changes in the colors and tones of your final image, and it wouldn't be desirable. And looking here, I can see, well, my reds are probably spot on. My greens could come down just a little bit, and my blues could come down a little bit. So rather than adding new points out here, what I'll do is I'll drag my original points around and make these adjustments to get it a little closer this way. Bring my blues down just a little bit as well. Now, the important thing to take away from this is that this is kind of a guide. This doesn't have to be an exact number. You don't have to hit these exact numbers, and I highly recommend you actually look at your image here in the canvas and see what these curve adjustments are doing to your final image. Let your eye be your final guide about how well the tones are matching. And you can see the results aren't bad. It's reasonably close. I could probably continue back and forth between midtones and high tones, and kind of adjusting these two points as I go, until I kind of tweak in something that I like. But compared to the original, and having a look at the application of our final curve, and it does get us reasonably close to the tones, but that's the basic idea. I hope this has been helpful.